This morning, the search for the fugitives known as the Devil's Rejects resulted in a violent clash with police. The three suspects connected to the House of 1000 Corpses murders were stopped dead in their tracks today. All three suspects remain in intensive care at Mercy of Christ Memorial. Doctors say chances for survival are less than a million to one.
May 23rd, 1978. This is the day three of the most infamous outlaws in the history of American crime seemingly met their final fate. 20 bullet wounds apiece. No one would have thought it possible that a single body could survive such a devastating onslaught of destruction, but they did. Over the next year, the critically injured outlaws of mayhem found their way back to the land of the living. The ensuing trial would be the longest murder trial in American history. Perhaps because of the massive press coverage the rejects received, they became martyrs to the youth.
They're cool, man. I think it's all a big conspiracy. They know that Captain Spaulding is the man, and they know that he knows what this country needs, you dig?
Spaulding says, fuck you and your system. I'm in control.
I don't believe she did it. It is obvious to me that she is not capable of those things. No way.
Peace and love.
Baby. Oh, man. She's got it going on, you know? I mean, I like the way that she moves. It's like she's floating on a cloud or something. She's amazing.
Spinning on the TV.
I mean, I think Otis is sexy. You know, I mean, I know he's a bad man and he's done some bad things, but, like, I date him.
You wanted the goddamn boogeyman in your sunny little lives. Well, you got him. There's no fucking justice in this world. I am justice.
They're trying to blame us, but we didn't do it.
Free the three.
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 Bain County Correctional. For the last 10 years, Warden Virgil Dallas Harper has been responsible for housing the two most famous killers since Burke and Hare.
For the past decade, you've kept Spaulding and Otis isolated from each other. Now, do you see the duo as a threat?
I don't find them a threat, no threat at all. Especially Spaulding. He's a geriatric corpse with one boot in the grave and the other dancing around the edge. I don't see him as a menace to anyone except himself.
Today, guys, anytime. Which one of you geniuses doing the interview?
Yeah, I am. Thank you for taking the time to do this. You ready?
I ain't getting any younger.
You dressed as a clown, but behind that colorful facade of joy lurks something much darker. Who is the real Captain Spaulding?
Goddamn, boy, could you get more dramatic? Well, what I ain't is the fantasy created by the injustice system and all them apes. That's all on them.
So you're saying...
I'm saying I'm just a clown dancing for the fucking man.
A dancing clown that's been convicted of 38 murders.
I'm gonna slap the shit out of you. Let me put it to you this way. What's the difference between a dead squirrel laying in the road and a dead clown laying in the road?
Yeah, I don't understand the question.
Do I stutter?
I don't know.
There are skid marks in front of the squirrel. You rolled that around in your coconut for a while, big shot.
So you think you were railroaded by the system because you're a clown?
I am what they make me. I'm your bozo Jesus hung out to dry for the sins of mankind. Oh, fuck. All hail the man behind the grease paint.
Early this morning, Captain Spaulding, the killer clown, was executed by lethal injection.
It was carried out quietly. He did not resist. There was no violence.
His last words was just give my love to my family and to my friends.
Those who saw him die have no remorse.
You see all these maniacs that they're running around thinking that this nut job, this killer, is some kind of great person? Well, he's not. You know what he is? He's the devil!
Spaulding was pronounced dead at 5:54 a.m.
You know what they say? All the world loves a clown.
Is Otis the most dangerous man alive?
He's nothing. He's like the rest of the lifers rotting in the cages here. Bunch of nothings.
Yeah, I think I know what you're looking for. We're just looking for the truth. You wouldn't know the truth if I crammed it down your fucking throat. Boy, you're marked. Christ, you're already dead. You just don't know it. The truth is the truth. The truth is a fucking knife. It cuts deep and it cuts both ways. Which end of the buck knife are you holding? The handle or the blade? You don't even know. So what do you want? Shall I break down in tears and confess my sins to the holy fucking pussy of the Virgin? I'm not a bad man. I'm just another lost soul searching for forgiveness in this wicked, wicked world. Hello, America. Did you miss me? I am Satan's destroyer. I am the eternal flame of salvation burning through your life, your liberty, and your pursuit of fucking happiness. I suggest you get ready to burn, motherfucker.
The footage you are about to see was shot on the morning of October 2nd, 1988. The filmmakers who documented this did not survive the experience.
I remember you.
I don't remember you.
You will, motherfucker.
Mark detail, toes on the line. Move up. Go! Start digging.
The following piece of film is the only clue that police have concerning the escape of Otis Driftwood. Viewer discretion is advised.
Who are you?
Payback's a bitch, motherfucker.
Public enemy number one, motherfucker! Number one!
This man is Winslow Foxworth Coltrane, a.k.a. the Midnight Wolfman, and the half-brother of Otis Driftwood and Baby Firefly. The Driftwood escape left a horrifying crime scene of death in its wake. As of the airing of this program, Otis Driftwood is still at large.
Incredible savings to half off and more on living rooms, bedrooms, and dining rooms. Layaway free for up to a year.
I look like a fucking stooge! Bam! He escapes on camera with a massacre to rub in my face.
Christ, Virgil, it wasn't your fault, I know that.
Of course it ain't, I know that, you know that. But the illiterate public doesn't. Do you think Ma and Pa Kettle reading about those dead fucking prison guards? He's gonna pin the blame on them? No. They're fucking heroes!